our beginning tonight with Santa Cruz police officers getting ready to return to work for the first time since two fellow officers were killed in an ambush on Tuesday.
In that interview, Goulet suddenly surprised the officers, produced a weapon, and shot and killed them within seconds.
And that news is not making it any easier to plan memorial services for the detectives, Butch Baker and Elizabeth Butler.
Tonight, our team coverage continues with more information on the memorial and the officers returning to duty.
But we are beginning with the latest on the investigation and Action News reporter Phil Gomez, live from Santa Cruz. Phil?
Detectives Butch Baker and Elizabeth Butler were ambushed when they tried to speak with Jeremy Goulet. He was a suspect in a sexual assault complaint. The two officers were dead in seconds after Goulet fired at them with his own .45 caliber weapon.
We now know that the detectives had absolutely no chance to protect themselves or return fire.
The two detectives spent 20 minutes searching for Jeremy Goulet's home in the Branciforte neighborhood when they encountered this man, who they at first believed was Goulet.
It seemed to me that they're, with the way they were reacting with me, that they knew that there was a tense situation, either because he wouldn't come to the door or whatever it was, and they seemed to be pretty edgy.
Flowers now rest where the two officers fell. Santa Cruz County Sheriff Phil Wowak says the detectives had no time to react.
Neither officer was wearing body armor at the time of the incident. However, body armor would not have helped.
It's also believed that this ladder truck may have diverted Goulet back into this apartment complex where he got into a shootout with police. Firefighters moved bystanders out of harm's way. One of them even shielded a woman from gunfire when she fell to the ground.
I think they were out doing their job. They did a great job. They protected the citizens of the city. This is a first for our city, and we share in the grief and the loss of the two police officers.
He stopped somewhere and put on a bulletproof vest.
The investigation into the police officers' deaths is far from complete. Search and rescue members were going door to door trying to find more video or witnesses. And Goulet was a suspect in another sex case.
Goulet is actually the suspect in an inappropriate touching of a juvenile woman or a juvenile child, a female. And we're following up in that investigation as well.
There were four officers who took down Goulet, three Santa Cruz police officers and a sheriff deputy. They're on administrative leave, which is standard procedure for officers involved in shootings. They're also receiving counseling. Police found Goulet's passport on his body and a plane ticket for New Mexico as well. Dan and Aaron.
All right. All right. Thank you, Phil.
Well, today we learned that Santa Cruz police will go back on patrol tomorrow. That announcement coming as plans have been finalized to honor their fallen comrades.
We get that part of the story from Action News reporter Felix Cortez, who is live outside Santa Cruz Police Department.
Well, Aaron, Dan, it's been 2 days since this tragedy, and as we heard today, nothing is getting easier. A department still in mourning, but its force headed back to work tomorrow.
Maria Alvarez of Watsonville knows what the families of Lauren Baker and Elizabeth Butler are going through. Her father was also a cop who lost his life fighting drug traffickers in Mexico.
They left in the morning, and they know, do they come back? And they not come back anymore. That same thing happened with my father, too. So it's sad. It's really sad.
There have been a lot of tears shed behind these walls, a lot of tears shed in this community.
And it comes as a makeshift memorial for the fallen officers continues to grow. The first deaths in the department's history.
No, there's no playbook for this. We've never been through this. We don't have guidelines. We just don't even know what the next steps are. We couldn't even tell you what to do next.
As of Thursday, the entire Santa Cruz police force was still on leave as they tried to cope with the tragedy. Police Chief Kevin Vogel announced late Thursday his force will be back on the streets Friday morning.
Ask the community that when you see our officers out patrolling our streets tomorrow, please provide them with all of the love and support that we can. It's been a tough 2 days here at the police department. We've got a rough week ahead of us.
a police force grieving, trying to make sense of this tragedy while at the same time organizing a memorial service for their fallen comrades. That service will be held Thursday morning at the Kaiser Permanente Arena in downtown Santa Cruz.
There's been just such an outpouring from the community at large and then around the nation, I'd even say around the world. We're getting emails from all of them.
Time for us to heal, a long time for us to fully get back to a sense of normalcy.
And you could say that tomorrow begins a process of trying to get back to some sense of normalcy here at the Santa Cruz Police Department as its force once again hits the streets of Santa Cruz. Their first briefing since this tragedy happened, scheduled for tomorrow morning at 7. Aaron, Dan.
All right, Felix. I mean, we want to go over those memorial service plans again.
The plans have been finalized for the memorial service. That happened this afternoon. So here is what we know so far. The memorial service will be held in the Kaiser Permanente Auditorium beginning at 11 o'clock on Thursday, March 7th. That's a week from today. They will put an overflow crowd at the Civic Auditorium and possibly even a third location. Haven't quite figured out exactly where that might be.
In addition to the memorial services that are planned for officers Butler and Baker, the city is working to help the families. Bank accounts where you can donate have been set up. You can contribute simply by going to cityofsantacruz.com.